All right, guys, back down here at the base camp today on a nice little snowy day in January. It's about 30 degrees out, just cold enough to give us some flurries. So I'm gonna do something a little different today, cook up a lunch. So I'm gonna go, I gotta go gather some materials. Maybe I need to build a back for this chair. I need to go get some materials, get this fire going so we can get to cooking. What they say is right. Honeysuckle, although invasive and ugly, can still serve a purpose. So it's winter time and there's so much snow on the ground. I'm trying to figure out how to get a fire to actually light, you know? There's gotta be a way.
Hack, fire hack. If you're trying to build a fire in the winter, don't do it. Don't build the fire in the snow. Fire is the opposite of water. Snow is water. Move it out of the way. Don't use your hands, cause it'll kill you. Use a stick. Use a stick, stick will die. But if you use a dead stick, you're not killing anything. You're innocent. Snow, winter snow fire hack.
All I'm really trying to do is give me some semi-dry wood to start my fire on. Just trying to make some little shavings to light up easily inside of this white pine. Just trying to clean the bark up off of this. This is gonna be like a toggle that I hang through the handle of my cooking pot. It's a piece of honeysuckle. Just cut a piece off that's a little bit wider than the handle of the pot. So here's the cook pot. Take the toggle, slide it through like that. And then what you've got is a string locking this into place to hang it above your fire. So I take my tag, fold it over at about 4 inches, like that, so it overlaps. Then take that, where it's doubled up, and just tie like a regular little knot. And what that leaves you with is your cordage. Maybe if you had a different color background, it'd be helpful. Leaves you with your cordage, the little loop. And then you can take your toggle, wrap it around, and then just pull your other end of your cordage through that loop you just made. Essentially serves the same purpose as a bowline, like that. Look at the toggle action, bow. Then you just take your other end of your cordage, tie it up to the top of your tripod that's gonna sit over top of your fire for cooking. I'm just gonna hang like that. So I really just need to tie a little knot up here. Probably would have been a good idea to knock all the snow off the tripod before I put it over my fire. Cutting board is a little bit slippery and dirty. But first step is for me to get a little bit of olive oil inside my cooking pot today and start browning up the sausages I brought out. They're actually beer brats. We gotta get this over the fire. Drop down, put that toggle through the handle, like that. Oh, gotta make sure the string is centered on the toggle. Could have been an issue if it wasn't. Like that. Except you want it in the middle. Like that. And if it's heating up too quickly, I can just pull it up, wrap it around one more time like that. Of course, it's making all kinds of noise because oil and water don't mix and it's snowing out, so it's cracking, popping. So I'm gonna take 2 beer brats and drop them into oil. Ooh, it's smoky. Dang it, man. Always getting freaking smoke in my eyes. All right, I really just need to brown these up. Look at the brown sausage. That's one way to flip a sausage. All right, so I just need to brown them up. A couple minutes on each side. Super wide toggle would have been better. 2 inches on each side isn't enough. I already dropped this thing once. There we go. All right, so I gotta start cutting up my vegetables and stuff for this beer brat lunchtime. So I brought myself a yellow onion, peppers, potatoes. I've got a pretty good little mixture of stuff to throw in this pot. All right, I've got garlic, onion, some peppers, a lot of different stuff, honestly. Whoa, onion overboard.
trying to keep chunks today, big chunks. Whoa! So I got a bigger cutting board today. Hopefully it'll make things a little easier, but it's still not that big. I mean, once you get to cutting up ingredients and stuff, take up some real estate on this thing, you don't really have that much room. Unfortunately, I broke it. You guys can see right there, this thing was brittle and it broke very easily, so. Got potatoes. I'm gonna have these yellow potatoes also. Oh, great. Drop the pepper. Maybe if I put these things down on their flat sides, they won't roll as much. One more is good. Full spread right there. Got the onions, peppers, and the little baby potatoes. Pretty good. All right, got this stuff prepped. Got to cut up a little garlic, and then this stuff's ready to go in. I don't really know how much garlic to put in, so two. It is very nice out today. The only issue is that the snow that's coming down is very wet. So I put this little tarp up just to give me a little bit of shelter for the time being. I wish it was about 10 degrees cooler. You know what I'm saying? If it's like 32 degrees, 31 degrees, 33 degrees, wherever, I feel like the snow is this really, it's good for snowballs, that's for sure. Really good for making snowballs. but it's very hard to, all the wood that I'm cooking on is just super wet, steaming, smoking a lot. Take a look at this prep bowl. Yeah, so I got the veggies prepped. The sausages are browned. That's the goal, just brown them up. Because this is a meal that takes a while to cook. So all you gotta do is brown the edges, get that little sear to them, a little flavor on them. And then you toss in your potatoes, your garlic, your onion, your sweet peppers. And cook that until your onions are sautéed. Once those are sautéed, probably like 7 minutes, you're basically just putting like a little glaze, a little heat, a little searing on these. Problem is my pot's not hot enough. And this is honestly like almost like a cast iron Dutch oven cooking recipe. You need more of a surface area than I'm getting with this pot. This is probably a 7 or an 8 inch pot, and it would be better if this whole thing was like a 12 inch cast iron deal, you know? I'm gonna have to get me a cast iron for these campfire cooking meals, but yeah, let's go ahead and get to the next step of cooking.
stir it up. Mix it up. There we go. There we go.
Look at all that aroma.
Smoke in the face.
Smoke in the face. Brutal.
Look at all the snow. Look at the scenery. Bam. Bam, son. Take that, JoJo. Stealing your lines. The little toggle's working out pretty good, huh? Except for the time I dropped it. But it's better than dropping bacon. There's the setup right there. Got the little rock fire reflector in the back. The good old-fashioned tripod going steady. Bank line in the house. Using bank line to tie it up to the top of the tripod.
With the setup like this, the tarp's kind of trapping the heat. So all these logs that had snow on them, all that snow's melting. So I'm just sitting here hanging out, chilling, minding my own business. Then I look up. Water dumping on my face. Man. This is a different one for me today, guys. Usually I do the breakfast videos. You guys love the breakfast. But honestly, this is my first real meal of the day, so technically it is a breakfast. All right, let's peep the beer for today. Let's do it justice. Let's get it all cleaned off. Show the ads. Show the beauty of the can. Look at that beer, boy. Look at that logo. All right, this is a local company from here in Ohio. This is called Yellow Springs Brewery Boat Show. India Pale Ale. Legit. This is I think parboiling sausages. It doesn't really matter what type of beer you have. I don't think you have to use a dark beer. I don't have any dark beer. Why? Because I don't like it. Tastes gross.
Beer.
I think that freaking logo is sick, isn't it? That's what I'm about. I buy beer based on what the can looks like. See? Know what I mean? All right, let's try the Boat Show. I've also brought out one to drink, which is called the American Pale Ale, same company. Support the local guys, you know? American Pale Ale Zoetic. This stuff is nice. I love this one. So we're going to do the orange one, the India Pale Ale, in the pot-a-roo. So let's get to dumping. Cheers, guys. Thank you to the Yellow Springs Brewery. Yeah, that's solid. Really good. Whew, that's so good. Now, kiddos, if you're not 21, you can't drink alcohols like this.
That's so good. Oh, man.
We got to put the herbs in. Gotta cook. Oh,
I forgot to put the last final flavors in this thing, which is some herbs. Got some basil, and I've also got some fresh sage. I think with this stuff, sage, you're only supposed to eat the leaves. This is some fancy stuff right now. I don't even know if you're supposed to cut these. Going in the pot.
The reason I love campfire cooking so much is because they're so, it's just like a cool little, it's so fun. So like right now,
the fire is kind of going out. The coal bed that I had was not great, honestly.
This is a slow cook recipe that needs to cook for like probably 45 minutes because you got potatoes. Potatoes cook take a long time to cook. So you're kind of simmering this thing for a long period of time.
I looked at it and I was like, I don't think this is hot enough. So, you know, I went out and picked out some stuff that's about as big as my thumb, a little bit bigger. Broke off 5 or 6 little pieces. You control the fire, you fiddle with the fire, you're cooking food. Building fires and cooking food's like the two best parts of camping. Sure isn't sleeping on the ground, and I love it. I've almost considered just doing all cooking videos from now on because it's so awesome, man. It's hard to put into words. If anybody watching this video has ever cooked food over a fire like this, you guys know what I'm talking about. If you haven't, I suggest you go try it. It's cool, man. Just sit real close to the fire. Get your little fire prep off to the side. Just watch your food cook and cook it.
It's good times.
So when I'm cooking my food, this is like the perfect time to clean up. You wouldn't believe how good this thing smells. I can already smell it. All the fumes coming off this thing, all the steam, all the flavor coming up off this meal.
All right, that's better.
Cleaned up a little bit. Now I'm gonna crack open the Zoetic. I love it, man. I love the campfire cooking. I love it more than actual camping. The reason I go camping is to just relax in front of a campfire and cook food. You don't have to spend the night in the woods to do that. You guys can get out into the woods for 4, 5, 6 hours just to build a little campsite and cook up some food. That's where it's at. I want to try lots of different stuff. Try a lot of different foods. Some of them are going to be typical, you know, family camping foods. Some of it might be some more of like the lightweight backpacking dehydrated stuff because I want to get back into making dehydration videos. Mixture. I want to do a good mixture. I want to do a lot of different videos on cooking, guys. Get some close up on this art. I used the Canon T3i for 5 years. That's what I used since basically I started my channel. At least since I started taking my channel for real. And man, I know that thing like the back of my hand. I come out and shoot videos, it's just so automatic. Now I'm using this, it's called a Panasonic Lumix GH4. It's a really nice camera, I'm just not used to it yet. I'm getting good. I'm getting better at it. I think I should probably stir the meal. Or at least check it, see if the beer level is still high enough. Oh baby. Looking good, isn't it? It's the potatoes. The potatoes are what take the longest, so I've just got to keep stirring it, make sure all the potatoes are getting heated up. Do some of the Zoetic, top it off. The little toggle's working out real good. See, right now I think it's too hot, so I can kind of break up the party, you know? So if I think it's too hot, I can, you know, easily just knock away the coals that are too hot. But I think it's fine. We're supposed to get 2 to 8 inches today of snow. This is our first good snow
this year. I think like the last two winters have been really mild. We used to have tons of snow. I remember growing up as a kid, we'd have snow days, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6 snow days a year where we got off school. So this meal is going to take, it says 45 minutes. The recipe that I used is less ingredients, less servings, I should say. So I don't know if that really impacts it too much. Same ingredients, just less of them. So I'm keeping my eye on it, checking it every 10 or so minutes to make sure it's looking good. Make sure that the beer level is high enough for it to keep cooking correctly. So far, so good. It smells amazing. While I'm waiting for my food to cook, I'm thirsty, so I got a survival hack.
If you're using a tarp, you can collect snow and rain for water. Like that.
It was cold. Tastes good, though. Tastes a little bit like tarp.
Yeah, definitely some tarp. Definitely some tarp flavor. Mint flavored tarp.
What an invention. I got the fire built back up because I needed some heat coming off that thing.
Cold. I'm a little bit cold.
I got gloves. Makes me think of Dumb and Dumber.
You mean to tell me you've had an extra pair of gloves this entire time? Yeah.
So stupid.
I am hungry, so I'm ready to eat. So let's get this thing going, you know? So today, 2 beer brats, about 1/4 of a yellow onion, 2 cloves of garlic, 4 or 5 sage leaves, a little sprinkle of basil, India Pale Ale beer at the bottom, and 5 little yellow baby Yukon potatoes. I think that's it. If you guys are still watching to this point, thank you. A lot of rambling on. One beer's got me on a little level. One beer's got me tight. One beer's got me tight.
Yeah, I don't drink. I don't really drink, so I cannot handle alcohol.
One beer's got me tight. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. Two can be two. As bad as one is the loneliest number since the number one. I want you guys to see what I see.
I need to get a wide angle lens. Beautiful out. It's beautiful out today. I wish when it was winter, it would just snow like this every day. Maybe I should move up to Canada. When I was a kid, I thought I was going to move to Canada. I always thought I'd live in Vancouver, which probably isn't as much snow. It's probably mostly rain up there, Pacific Northwest. But yeah, I grew up skateboarding. My favorite skateboarder was from Canada, from Vancouver. And I always loved hockey. I played hockey a lot when I was a kid. Here in Ohio, it was roller hockey. So, but yeah. Oh man, I love the snow. I like the winter way more than the summer. Look how beautiful out it is. Summertime's beautiful also, but just different. You guys know where I'm at? Treehouse build project. Decided to go a little hike. Beautiful, beautiful weather. Man, this is awesome. I love snow.
Look at all that beauty, boy.
Awesome out. back to camp. I gotta get this food done so I can eat. I'm freaking starving.
Definitely time to eat.
Potatoes galore.
Dang it.
I didn't stir it enough. The bottom's burned, so I lost some of my flavors. But in reality, you're eating this for the sausage and the potatoes, not for the peppers. Those are just flavors. Check that out. Holy moly. So yeah, I don't know why you throw the peppers in so early. Peppers and onions cook down to nothing. So it doesn't make a whole heck of a lot of sense that you throw them in and cook them for 45 minutes, but who am I? I'm just a noob. Let's take one of these sausages out and cut it up. First bite of the sausage. Oh, that's so good. That's good. I'm not messing around. That is so good.
Ooh, there you gone gold.
The mini potato, a little bit of onion dangling, a little dangling.
Man, that's good.
Sausages. This is so good, guys. They're called beer brats. It's a sausage you make.
Look at that flavor. Look at all that. Man,
look at that. Peep that. So good, guys. So freaking good. Potatoes are too hot. Potatoes are way too hot. But yeah, I was kind of hoping to eat the sweet peppers, but they kind of cook down to nothing. There's a righteous potato right there. Legit potato. Probably could have done without cooking this last 5 or 10 minutes. I could have taken it off. So good, man. Kind of crazy looking, isn't it? Almost like a stewy mix. But yeah, I goofed up a little bit. I went off hiking around, messing around. And you do need to monitor it. You do need to stir it every once in a while. If you guys see the bottom of the pot, I got some burn action, which probably means some of my sausage looks great. The potatoes are great. It must have just been like the onions and peppers that fell to the bottom burned up.
Legit, dude. So good. Do you potato? Put a little tiny potato, put a little potato on a little sausage, a little two-course meal.
Cheers, guys. Appreciate you guys watching this one.
Yeah, that was good. That was solid.
Only mistake I made, well, I made a lot of mistakes. First mistake I made is I should have built my fire back up as soon as I was done cooking, because now the fire is dead. It is cold over here. But cooking, in terms of cooking it, the mistakes I made was you probably don't have to throw the peppers in at the beginning. Maybe you're supposed to, maybe you're not. But I threw the peppers in right at the beginning and they melted away to nothing. I would have loved to just bite into a bite of sausage, a bite of onion, a bite of potato, and a bite of pepper. All combined, a little perfect mixture of flavor. But they were all wilted down to nothing within, you know, 30 or 40 minutes of cooking over the fire. Second mistake I made is you gotta stir it. You gotta stir it every 5 or 10 minutes, unless you're doing it really slow cooker style, like a crock pot at home. Because eventually the bottom, the ingredients touching the bottom, burned up. But overall, man, it tasted amazing. I learned I didn't need a cast iron skillet. Dutch oven. You don't need a Dutch oven for this type of meal. You just use a big pot like the one I used today, and you can do just fine. I also learned 2 sausages and 5 potatoes wasn't quite enough.
All right, guys, I'm packing up camp. Time to go. It is getting dark and cold out in a hurry, so I'm gonna pack up camp and get up on out of here. But, sorry, trying to jog. Get some heat. But I appreciate you guys watching. I really do. If you guys have never tried beer brats while camping, it's worth a shot, for real. Oh, it was super good, and I would do it again any day. I did forget to bring a food prep knife. The old Mora isn't great for food prep. It's kind of a wide, robust, full tang knife, so I need to get a food prep knife. I need to order me an open nail or something. But I appreciate you guys watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. And until next time, Scrambled O signing off.